Hello and welcome everyone to part one of my Imperator Augustus Octavian campaign for Total War Rome 2. This is the first part of my brand new Let's Play with the Imperator Augustus campaign pack. Now, some of you are going to be slightly disappointed that this is Octavian's Rome. I know Surreal Beliefs, I believe, is doing one. I think he's doing one on Legendary difficulty. I did ask people whether I should play on Very Hard or Legendary, and the majority voted for Very Hard. That was through my social media links of Twitter and Facebook. So I'm going to go for Very Hard for now to see how this plays out. If this goes really well, I will certainly be doing more campaigns on the Imperator Augustus campaign pack, or campaign itself, so fear not, and maybe I'll do one of those as Legendary if that's what you guys and gals crave. So yeah, I know Surreal's doing one, but at the end of the day, I can't help it, guys. This is what you voted for. This is what the majority voted for. And if it wasn't going to be Octavian, it would have been Pompey, and I already know a couple of YouTubers that are doing Let's Plays on that. I already know there's a couple doing Anthony. I'm not sure about Lepidus, actually. That's probably quite an untouched one. But it was quite likely to be a Roman faction. So I know it might seem a bit obvious, the blatant one, but then again, I did do Rome, Iceni, and Sparta when Rome 2 first came out. So I hope you'll enjoy this Let's Play. Even though it's Rome, and we've been here before, there's a lot of changes with the Imperator Augustus pack, mainly because it's part of the Emperor Edition for Rome 2 that just came out today, patch 15. There's a substantial amount of changes. So I'm going to be playing it on Very Hard, and without further ado, let's get started.
You are my son, but I've done all I can to protect you.
The gods smile on you, Octavian. You're a good soldier.
I'm a politician.
We don't need more politicians. It's not more speeches in the Senate that will change the world. Rome is dying.
Why do you think Caesar favored you so?
I was loyal.
No, Octavian. He saw in you the potential to continue his legacy. Not to follow him, but to exceed him.
Antony cannot be trusted. His heart lies in Egypt. We must confront the reality that civil war is inevitable.
And how will bloodshed save the people of Rome?
You are not meant to save them. You are meant to lead them.
Troubled when their moment has come.
I am not Caesar. I don't have his strength.
The people loved him, and they will love you.
You can't think like an ordinary man. You must reach beyond mortal ambition and do what has never been done.
Survive, my son. Rome must have a master.
Now you have the chance to surpass the exploits of your glorious predecessor. Alliance with Mark Antony and Lepidus, however tenuous, gives you the space to protect and extend your domains. Once again, your Gaulish friends are menaced by migratory Germans. Defeat them, and take the chance to conquer their lands for Rome's glory. Also, pay heed to Pompey, the son of your father's enemy, whose fleet continues to menace your coast. Remember, however, that your ultimate goal is leadership of the Republic. When relations break down, this must be your focus to the exclusion of all else. Seize your birthright. Seize the day.
Seize the day. You are not meant to save them. You are meant to lead them. I love that trailer. Love that intro. Big fan. Anyway, so we have an objective, completely controlled 10 provinces, either by direct ownership or through client states and military allies. New bonus suggestions have been added to your objectives list, plus 2,500 treasury. Let's have a quick look at that. We already have 8. The bonuses are be at war with the following faction, Pompey's Rome for 1,000. Control one of the following settlements either by direct control. Control the following one settlements. Okay. Well, I don't have that one. Days of Futures Past. I'd have to really push for that. And military victory. We need 100 settlements. The client states or military allies. We have 25 in total at the moment. We're going to hold Sicily, Africa, and Macedonia. So that's where we've got to go. Okay. So, as I was saying, I hope you guys enjoy this Let's Play. I know it's Rome again, but there's alterations to the map. There's more provinces. There's more factions. This is Rome as we've not seen it before. And obviously, I know some of you are going to want to watch the Real Belize version of this, and hopefully some of you want to watch mine. But either way, hope you enjoy the content, and as I mentioned, there will be more Let's Plays featuring the Imperator Augustus campaign in the future. So if this one isn't for you, that's fine. Check out my other Let's Plays, really appreciate it. And, you know, do come back in time to enjoy some Imperator Augustus. So, let's have a look here. We can get legionaries or we can get first cohort. First cohort, pretty badass across the board. Quite a high upkeep, so we'll just throw... Well, we can throw two of them in there. I can recruit a stupid number of units in an army in one go now. That's crazy. That's because of the bonuses that Rome gets, provincial effects, so we get plus two army recruitment capacity. Which is obviously new in this pack. So pumping out all those legionaries rather than upgrading my economy straight away may not be the smartest thing in the world. I was mainly just going, ooh, look, units. So let's have a look at things before we jump into that. We have these guys as our client state. Let's try and get trade with them.
Greetings, friend. We will speak together of whatever you wish, but bring words that can warm our hearts.
Yeah, that'll do.
Speak quickly.
Anthony's a wee bit peed off. What I've learnt, because those of you that may have been watching Creative Assembly's Total War channel recently, their Twitch channel rather, I've been live streaming on their channel over the last couple of days. I've been looking at the Iceni and Pompeii, and I will be uploading the Pompeii recording to my channel soon. The Iceni one basically just had too many stop starts to it because I had some streaming problems.
I trust you come with honourable words that I can.
But I hope you guys
kindly
will enjoy seeing that content. Oh no!
All would surely benefit if we agreed to open trade. Excellent, my people.
But I've had a chance to have a look at briefly at the game.
I welcome you, worthy speaker. I listen because your people are known to have honour.
But I really enjoyed the Pompeii Let's Play, so I may well do that as a live stream series.
To be sure.
So again, this is kind of, I know I've just started this Let's Play off and I should really be promoting this one and going, yeah guys, definitely enjoy this one, check this one out. But the thing is, this always happens when a new game comes out and when there's other YouTubers all doing the same thing. And I know somebody said, well, why don't we, you know, why didn't I restrict the number of Roman factions because it was bound to be chosen? The thing is, it comes down to the fact that, you know, necessarily why should it be, you know, me that, I guess, caps the factions or something like that, because I just wanted to open the forum up, open the polls up to see what you guys wanted. I'm not bothered with faction I play. I think they're all pretty interesting, even if I had played them similarly before. So that's why I didn't like restrict which factions you guys could choose, and what have you. Just thought I'd probably clear up some questions that are bound to be asked early on. Thought we'd get them sorted. Well, we got loads of things we can upgrade. Ooh, this is something I really do enjoy. Now, villages with specific resources now show that in their building, their village section here. So this is a gold mine here, and if we go to the next one up, we can see how that'll progress. And also, you have different upgrades for your cities. You have a garrison colonia, or you have a civil colonia. Obviously, that one is more towards the military, better garrison units. And this one more for the economy and growth. And this gives you more public order if those fronts are troubling you. So it really is a huge overhaul here in Rome 2 of a lot of functions, a lot of features, and a lot of the building trees. So yeah, this is the Emperor edition, and it feels good. So I could upgrade these bits, but I've spent Oh, I've just gained loads of money because I've just been trading. I'm getting loads of money that way. So let's start upgrading some stuff. Well, let's start off with Rome. Let's start off in the heartland and expand on out. I guess we probably should expand. Let's expand Rome to start with. Get the Roman ballista if I wanted to, but that requires battering ram technology. So for now, are we good with our Latin culture? We are indeed. Well, let's go for... We can obviously get gladiators, I would assume, from them later on. So let's go for suburbia. Let's go for some wealth there. We could upgrade here. Expand the city. Let's do that. Put this large vineyard, which obviously gives us various bits to trade with. I've got the pit mine, the villa, the meeting place. I'm going to go for the meeting place. I love all these new buildings. It really does feel like a completely refreshed game, which is awesome. We can upgrade these as well. Let's upgrade Brundisium. This is my main city down here. And we've already got two manipular barracks, which we don't need. So one of these is going to get converted over to the cohort, the auxiliary camp, rather. And that means this can go over... What's our public order like? Oh, that's fine. Let's go... Oh, not public order, our culture, rather. Let's go over to a suburbia as well. Let's really try and push the economy. What have we got there? We've got Olive Press. It really does make settlements feel a lot more unique, a lot more interesting with all these various bits to them. Massalia can be upgraded, but I can't afford any more this turn. So who are we at war with to start with? We're not at war with anyone. We have defensive alliances with Lepidus. I was calling it Lepidus, but Lepidus and Anthony. We have these guys as our clients. So that's pretty good. So it's looking for someone that's weak that we can take out to start with. They're our client. These guys... We could go against these guys here. We could start pushing to the north. Or, you know, we got to wait for really Anthony to get annoyed with us so we can go to war with him. Or we could go down towards Pompeii and take him out pretty quickly because we're not allied to him at all. So I think that's what we're going to do. We're going to go swoop down and take out Pompeii. We've got their settlement over here. They have 7 units. They're going to spawn 9. So unfortunately that fleet's not enough. But this army at Rome could swoop on over next turn and take it. They're not really strong enough. I'll probably start getting rid of some of these vigilantes as well. Let's pop this veteran in Augustus's army. And obviously the politics has been overhauled as well. The politics screen. We can now see a shift between the various influences here. Respected by all, if perhaps not listened by everyone. We have a civil war indicator there for when we're going to get civil war, and you can have multiple civil wars now in a campaign. So we're going to come down and take out Pompeii first. We're trying to take out its satellite states over here. These guys are over here. We'll leave them for now. They can be upgraded. Yeah, we'll leave them for now because I don't know if we'll have to move on the border. Because it kind of, I always find this. I always probably start asking, oh, where should I go in my first turn? Or who should I declare war with? And then suddenly all these factions will start declaring war with me and it will sort itself out. So I'm just going to aim for Pompeii. But we'll also see if there's anything else that needs doing. But I think that's all we can do. So this guy's up there. Yep. Right, let's end the turn. Nope. Issue an edict. Makes a lot of sense. Let's go for... Bread and Games. Pretty standard. Can probably do another one as well, I would have thought. Yep, we'll go for more Bread and Games. I would assume I can only do the two. Yep, I need a high level of Imperium. End the turn, we're getting 6k to start with, so that should be alright. This is slated as an easy campaign. Obviously I'm playing on the very hard setting. Oh, look at that smooth, fast end turn. Boom. And this Let's Play is uploading on Tuesdays, Thursdays, and Saturdays alongside the Idrisian Kingdom. Just in case you guys are wondering. Okay, edicts issued, quarter master report, lots of units being recruited, which is all good. That's what we want. Right, this army from Rome. Oh, I can't get over there quickly enough. Put your backs into it, you We're going to hit these guys first, that's why I'm sailing across very quickly. Or trying to, it's taking me a while. Right, with the rest of the money, I guess we could start upgrading civil settlements from the centre rather than constantly expanding all these ones, but I will expand some of them. Brundisium can be expanded again. We've got the quarry there already, so let's go for one of these. Obviously could upgrade this as well. Let's go for the... You know, let's go for the garrison Colonia, just in case Anthony does attack us earlier. We could just strike him, but I don't want to break all my treaties just yet. I don't want to incur the wrath of Lepidus as well. So we'll take our time there. Masale, you can be upgraded. And you can be upgraded several times, actually. Go for one of those, and one of those. Talossa, yeah, we'll upgrade you, and you can be a pit mine. Midland. Oh, no, it's not Midland, it's Medio Alanium. They've changed some of the names here. Have to keep an eye on that. Some Celtic culture here, so they've got a Neptune one there. There is some Latin culture. Let's pop that in there, though, anyway, just to make sure. Go for a farm, a villa. I can upgrade a few more of these over here, but we're going to have to wait a few turns before we can do that. That's okay, though. I'll start recruiting more troops when I can. We're going to go push out straight with Octavian, hit Pompey, and I'm probably going to need to bring another army down there, so let's force march these guys to defend. End the turn. Kind of waiting for everyone to start attacking or breaking alliances. We're going to go for Illyria first. Non-aggression pact with Pontus. Yeah, we'll take that. Once I sort out the other kind of Roman factions, and I think this becomes quite... Well, it gives you easy targets to go for to start with. You know, hopefully... we're going to have to worry about all these troubled populace. That's what we've got to worry about straight away. Okay, well, we need to get public order under control. May well need to get some more generals in as well. And they're going to be from the other houses, all of them, aren't they? Octavian Dynasty, you've got this guy here. Yeah, let's pop him here for now. Veteran legionaries. Ready for orders. I do want to upgrade that really badly, but it's going to cost me a lot to do. So I'd rather just expand these settlements where I can, or go for industry to start with. Making sure we've expanded as much as we can to start with. There's nowhere else that we could expand that we're missing. And then we'll start expanding from the centre. With these, so we've got civil settlement, farming settlement, or market settlement, more commerce, agriculture. Probably go from commerce, I would have thought. Yeah, we've got a lot of commerce there. We could go for harbour, which will get commerce. That's commerce as well. Public order for the auditorium. So let's go for the market settlement here. Which is what we can get now. Oh, wow, that's really cutting our movement range. If we go to here, we should be able to attack in normal stance next turn with these guys blockading. Just got to watch out for that army, which I believe has ballista in it. And and some onager ships, only because I played as Pompey earlier in the live stream. We'll see where they're going. With Pompey, I went straight over here. See, Lepidus is moving down there. Well, let's say you already start with it. Let's get a dignitary next. As per usual, I should say, feel free to throw all sorts of, you know, advice in the comments. Do be kind, of course, but feel free to advise me as I go. We'll see how this handles. Obviously, I've got to get used slightly differently. Oh, here we go. They will set their swords to your people. They refuse to join my side. That's cool. So they've broken their alliances, so that's fine. It means I can go and attack Anthony if I want, and Lepidus. But not for now, we're going to focus on Pompey. Oh, and we've got developmental focus. Military development, research rate, or civil. Well, we're going for some civic policies at the moment. So we'll go for the civil development. Loads of construction. Population surplus. Needs to go for a temple, that's what's upsetting people over here. Trouble populous. Nabo Mauritius. No, it's not Nabo Mauritius. Nabo Nenis. Nenis. Nensis. Nabo Nensis. Right. We are Latin here, are we not? We're just a bit upset. Well, let's go for the amphitheatre for public order. I have to keep an eye on my food as well. I'm going to get some squalor from that. Shrine of Jupiter. I'll go for the garrison there. That's all our money for this turn. Path blocked. Your orders. War target available.
Yes. Yes. Your order.
In we go. Um, 83% now. We'll fight this one. Why not? First battle we have. Away we go. Against Pompey's Rome. Dry. Yep, that'll do. So, invasion force landing. The only unit of cavalry that we're missing out on here is my general. But that's fine. I've got various places to land here, or we could land over there. Got the first cohorts. I'm going to split my infantry in two here. Some will land at the beach and then swing round. They're going to swing round with my general. Meanwhile, the rest are going to try and land at the front here. Support ships up over here to start with.
Our reinforcements have arrived.
So legionaries are going up over there. These guys can get in over here. These guys can land there. We've also got some reinforcements coming in as well. We're going to get these this lot. Some reason we can't land down all the way down there. Get them all to land over there for now. Bar these guys, you can land there. These guys coming toward us, should have moved these guys earlier. Just don't let them catch you. Already rammed. Naval battle still need tweaking, and I've been hit pretty heavily here. The men are already going down. Yeah, get out of the way, guys. Go, 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 go. No, run, 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 run. Run, 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 guys. I've been bombarded. I don't have a way of going faster, so I'll have to let these guys take the flak. Damn it. That's a shame. Guys, get ready to land here. Get ready to beach. At least they're not ramming me, but I doubt they're going to. Probably could turn around and ram them. We're just going to get these guys away from the enemy and on the shore. Lost enough men already. The men at the back of the ship. Shields facing the wrong way, so there's not much we can do here. Land already, men. Land, 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 land. Not a single ship here being untouched. So these guys are going in for a ramming here. They're trying to shunt my ships here. Do some damage. General, land. These guys are going to land anyway, so we'll be safe. So I'm going to move these guys over here instantly. This lot have landed. This one's moving in for here. Off the ships you go, men. Ready for battle. Does look glorious watching them jump off their ships, although not when that one's sinking. Right. Form your lines. You guys can join them in a second. Run, General, run, otherwise these raiding levies will come for you and try and kill you. Run, 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 run. We're gonna ignore them for now. They can try and chase us if they really want, but we're not bothered. Right, General, run up behind these guys. You guys are group two, and you're gonna form up here. Rest of them forming up over here. Getting into position. We've got veteran legionaries that are going to be down there. I'll give you guys the hard row. If you can get out of the way of all these ships here and not kill my own ships or get in the shunt them around. What do we got in the centre then? We've got a couple of legionaries, levies, plebs. So I'm actually going to hit fast forward while we wait for all my guys to assemble. We've got these levies coming behind us. These guys in attacking Testudo. Here we go, and we're going to go for their general here. And in close range, we can get the Pila throw, get the charge in if we can, if we're lucky. We're going to get it as well. Send these guys in as well to help them out, because otherwise they're going to be flanked pretty heavily. In my men go. Lots of damage. Well, they're charging me in, actually. And I do love now, this is a big feature, for me at least, for patch 15, Emperor Edition. You now have fire at will for all units that have missiles. So, Pila Throw, they will stand in defensive formation, and they'll use their Pila Throw if you have them standing still at an enemy, which is great. Obviously, they'll still do their throw on the charge there as they are coming in now. Oh, right through his face. Brilliant. Oh, through the gut. There we go. We're going to slaughter these guys here. That's fine. Back up here, we'll meet some a true test of our might. Some Roman legionaries. Pompey's legionaries. I was waiting for all my men to get up here. They're all the way over there, so we're not going to include them in this grouping, actually. I will get these guys over here, and I will move these guys up. Of auxiliary infantry as well. Pop my legionaries to here, because then again, in defensive formation, they have that fire at will with their Pila. It's really effective. Right, and with these guys, I'm going to split them into two sort of subgroups now. Two of you to move round to here. And you three to move round to here. And that's where my general's going to come as well. Guys forming up, ready to face the enemy legionaries. They've got plebs behind them, levies. We're going to have to hit them hard from all sides. That's why I'm getting all my men into position. And then we are going to strike.
Spear infantry at your command.
Legionaries!
These are the veteran legionaries. They're going to form up over here, charging from this street. Take these guys with him. He's sending legionaries this way. I know we're coming. First cohort, there you are. Levies. Moving in with everyone that's possible. Vigiles. Alright, let's push forward with these guys so that we can try and lure the enemy units in. Yeah, we're going to be able to hit them from here, which is good. And they're actually coming forward, which means we'll get to see these guys get their peeler out as well. Well, hopefully. We should get them out any moment now. These guys are going to have to retreat. These guys, there we go, they got their peeler, and they're throwing now. Defensively, it does a crazy amount of damage. Why you guys really going to have to use Testudo, I'd have thought. Oh, we're hitting them from all angles now, just whittling them down. That went straight over my shields there. I'm still going to let my men fire, because they can fire from the flanks, which is good. Pull these legionaries round. Push in with my general from here. Get these guys to attack the legionaries from here. And as you can see, we've absolutely slaughtered the enemy legionaries here in a far more defensive formation, which is brilliant. Now, there might need to be some tweaking, I reckon, to the amount of missiles these guys have. Because, really, a Roman infantryman would only carry, or a legionary would only carry two peeler, I believe, as far as I know. So, I think they have a fair few bit more than that, so there might need some tweaks to that for balancing. But still, I think armor's been buffed as well to offset for its the peeler. But then, most infantry units in the game have some kind of missile attack as well. Here we go, into these guys. Crashing in, legionaries. Shatter them from all sides. My legionaries pushing up from this side as well. Battles do feel a lot more satisfying now, which is good. Get the charge into the back of these guys here, the legionaries. I think we've got them shattered, though. Completely surrounded. The day is ours. We'll end the battle, a decisive victory. We lost 219. Enemy killed 189, so not too much friendly fire. 185 kills there from one of my legionary units, gaining the most kills. We killed 1,102 of the enemy 1,280. Very pleased with that indeed. That's a good number. That is good. Happy, happy Lionheart. Decisive victory, and I am going to... I've actually been trying looting out for a little bit, but that's a lot, so I'm just going to raise it, like raise normally. I could occupy Brolium, that would have been fine, but that does allow me to take the settlement and then push on as quickly as possible. Can't afford any more there, so we won't repair those two, and we'll build one of these, actually... We'll get more food for now.
Ready for battle.
And with those guys there, could get ready to push down towards Caralis down here. That'd be quite useful. Go for strategist. So that's that done. And I think we've got time for just moving these guys down here to Corsentia. Hold the line there. Syracuse, we can see they formed up. End the turn, and that's where we're going to wrap up the part as well. So, we've pushed out. We're at war with Pompey. I do hope you've enjoyed this first part. I do hope you've tuned in. And as I've said many, many times in this, if you guys, you know, if Octavian isn't the chap for you, I will be doing plenty more campaigns over the coming months in the Imperator Augustus campaign pack. So I will see you all again soon. Please remember to comment, subscribe, follow me on Facebook and Twitter, take pride and join the Legion. Ciao for now.